Oye, qué loca mi gente, yo soy Ricky de Bilingüe Vlogs. Gracias por estar aquí conmigo watching another video. If you're new to the channel, this is not another video for you, but it can be if you go ahead and subscribe and hit that notification button right now so that you can know when I upload a new video. You guys, if you don't know me, yo soy el americano más dominicano. But before I was el americano más dominicano, I was el americano hispanohablante muy tímido, mi gente. I wasn't always this confident speaking Spanish. And I want to give you 3 tips for how I became a confident Spanish speaker, so stay tuned for this video. A little bit of background about me. A lot of you guys have asked me this before, but if you're new, you don't know the story. So how long did it take me to learn Spanish? It took me 2.5 years to learn Spanish, but it took me about 4 years total, you know, so a year and a half after that 2.5 years to feel comfortable speaking with strangers in Spanish. So in those 2.5 years where I was learning and then I became fluent, I was speaking with friends, I was speaking with family, I was speaking with people that were kind of associates that I just felt comfortable with. But if I didn't feel comfortable with you, I was not going to speak Spanish to you. That's just how it went, because stranger danger, ya tú sabes. But no, I was just really nervous to do so. In that year and a half that I spent after those 2.5 years becoming comfortable speaking with strangers, this is what went through my mind. Step number one was that I had to think about, why did I learn Spanish in the first place? I know you've seen anime. I know you've seen anime. And in anime, the main character, he's always remembering his why. And it's usually his friends, close friends and family. And then he's able to pull this confidence out of him.
Pero loco, dime. ¿Qué tiempo hace aquí afuera?
It's... Wait, I don't have to revert to English. I just have to think about my new friends that I'll make when I can speak Spanish. And that Mexican girl in math class that I just love to sit behind. I can do this. It's about them too.
Hace sol.
Oh. Déjame quitarme esta chaqueta entonces.
What is your why? Is it because you found love, or is it to be able to speak more with your friends in a new country that you moved to? Is it for family? I learned because my best friend's dad was Colombian and his mom was African American, but she spoke fluent Spanish, so his whole family pretty much speaks Spanish. And I was over there and I wanted to communicate with them. Also, in middle school, I was like crazy about Spanish speaking girls. I wanted a Spanish speaking girlfriend, so I had to learn the language, right? That's what got me going at first. So now, you know, my why is I want to just be able to speak to anyone wherever I go. The second thing that you can do to become a confident Spanish speaker is, and this is key, this is major, to give this video a thumbs up, give it a like. Ya tú sabes que lo que hay, mi gente. It helps me to reach a lot more people, it helps the channel grow. Y yo quiero crecer, que lo que tú estás esperando. Dale like ya, suscríbete ya. Anyways, the real second thing is to realize that it's just a conversation. It's literally just a conversation. You are just speaking with someone else. You're transmitting your ideas. They're transmitting their ideas. You guys are talking about one topic, or it could be multiple topics, but it's just a conversation at the end of the day. I think a lot of people, a lot of us, when we are speaking Spanish, or we have the opportunity to have a Spanish speaking conversation, we treat it like this.
Hey, Roberto?
Ah, yes. Ricky, ¿cómo estás?
Bien, bien.
Ah, así que tú hablas español.
I speak a little bit of Spanish, man.
No, tú hablas español. Y yo te voy a decir que mira esto.
Whoa, what do you want? You want my wallet, my cell? What do you want?
No. Esto es lo que va a pasar. Tú me vas a hablar en español perfecto. Y si no, te presento a mi amigo señor Cuchillo.
Ok, te hablo en español.
Muy bien. Así que dime, Ricky. Ricky eras, ¿no? ¿Qué tú hiciste ayer?
Ayer fui al mercado. Y yo comí una pizza y hablabas con tu madre.
Ricky, casi perfecto. Pero loco, te callaste. Yo te pregunté qué tú hiciste. Y tú me dijiste que yo hablé con mi madre, o sea, that I spoke to my mother? Wrong again! No, it's weird, no!
Guys, nobody's holding you hostage with a knife. expecting you to get everything perfect in Spanish. Nobody's holding you at gunpoint. It's not that serious, guys. We have to take Spanish off of this pedestal and put it down here at the same level as English. We have conversations all the time with people in English, so just do the same thing in Spanish. Don't worry too much about being wrong. Don't become a grammar Nazi. Just have fun with the language. And that brings me to my third way, which is to stop caring. This is how I used to react when I used to make a mistake in Spanish.
Loco, pero yo no creo que esa es la verdad. Yo tampoco, pero déjame corregirte. ¿Huh? Se dice, no creo que sea la verdad. Ese es subjuntivo, loco. ¿Qué? No. No. Loco, pero ¿qué tú haces? ¿Por qué tú tienes que ser tan dramático?
Grammar books. I failed you again. I'm so sorry. I thought I knew Spanish.
Okay, maybe I wasn't that dramatic, but here's how I react nowadays when I make a mistake in Spanish.
Loco, pero yo no creo que esa es la verdad. Yo tampoco, pero déjame corregirte. Se dice, no creo que sea la verdad. Ese es subjuntivo, loco. Oh, ok, pues, gracias, loco. Tú sabes, no creo que sea la verdad. De nada, loco, pero tú sabes. Yo tampoco creo que sea la verdad, tú sabes, porque es...
Stop caring about making mistakes in Spanish. My Spanish, contrary to popular belief, is not perfect. And you know who else doesn't have perfect Spanish? Native Spanish speakers. They don't have perfect Spanish all the time either. They make mistakes too, but it's okay. We're not judging each other. Sometimes it makes for a funny situation and you have to be able to laugh at yourself and learn and use that as a learning experience to not feel that embarrassment. But at the end of the day, everybody makes mistakes, guys. Like I said, even natives do it all the time. So don't be so hard on yourself. Just have fun in the conversation. Learn. Learn new phrases, learn new words through mistakes, through trial and error. That's how I became as fluent as I am today. And when you speak English, you don't care if you make a mistake. When you're typing something on the computer, you don't care if you make a mistake. You just go backspace and you correct it. So do the same thing when you're speaking Spanish. Don't be so hard on yourself. Have fun with it. Just experience the language, live the language, immerse yourself more in the language, and the confidence will come with time. You have to consider these three things. And once you do that, I think the confidence will be there. I think the confidence will be there for you. So next time that you have an opportunity to speak Spanish with someone, don't chicken out. Don't just say sí all the time to everything. No, don't switch over to English. Speak Spanish with them. Just have the conversation. It's that simple. So hopefully you've enjoyed that video. If you did, go ahead and give it a like. Also, I want to know, what has your experience been as far as being a confident Spanish speaker? Let me know down in the comments, because I love to read your stories down in the comments. And I like the conversations that we can all have together, because we are a community. Ya tú sabes que, okay, mi gente? Also, make sure to share this video. You never know who may be learning Spanish, and some people may be lacking the confidence to carry on conversations in Spanish. So I think this video will be very helpful for them. If you agree, go ahead and share this video on your social media platforms. Ya tú sabes, hasta aquí el video de hoy. Nos fuimos, mi gente.